Morning children, I am Roshan Myers, your educator for English Standard 4 of LP Samani Vidya Bhavan. Here is a short story related to the poem on the importance of waking up early. How do you wake up in the morning? Does your mother wake you up? Do you wake up on your own or do you set an alarm? Do you get up happily or do you like to lazily be in bed? This lesson is about a girl, Neha, who, like most of the kids, loves to be in bed. When it's time to get ready for school, and that's the lesson one, Neha's alarm clock. So let's read the chapter. Narrator: ring, 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 off goes the alarm clock, 6 in the morning. Neha makes a face and, covering her ears with a pillow, snuggles under the warm blanket. But she knows she has to get up. She mutters to herself, "Neha, this alarm clock always rings at 6 and pulls me out of the bed. It's so unfair. Oh, how I would love to sleep a little longer in the morning. I wish this clock would forget its job sometimes." Narrator: something falls. Neha smiles. Neha: oh, my clock has fallen. How happy I am. Tomorrow, I can get up late. Explanation of the paragraph. The alarm rings at 6 a.m. and Neha covers her ears with a pillow to avoid hearing the ring. She is quite annoyed and wishes that the alarm would someday forget to ring. To her luck, the alarm falls down. Neha is happy and her wish was granted and she could get up late the next day. Next para. Next morning there is no alarm, so Neha sleeps and sleeps. The small chirpy birds would come to the windowsill every morning, find Neha still sleeping. Birds: wake up dear, wake up fast. Narrator: Neha gets up with a start. Neha: oh no, if it's not the alarm clock, it's these birds. Why don't they leave me alone? Explanation: the next day the alarm does not ring. Neha enjoys her sleep a little longer, but the birds, who always wake up on time, keep chirping and Neha once again is woken up. She wishes that the birds would leave her alone. Narrator: even this wish of Neha's comes true. The next morning, there is not only no alarm clock, there are no birds either. But there is someone else who does not want her to miss the school bus. Can you guess who is it? The big bright sun. He fills Neha's room with a warm smile. Neha: oh my eyes, now it's the sun waking me up. Why can't he let me be? Narrator: even this wish of Neha's comes true. Next morning the sun is behind the clouds, so Neha snores till she hears her mother's voice. Second wish is also granted. On the third day, the alarm didn't ring, the birds didn't chirp, but Neha was again woken up. The sunlight crept into her room and made it bright. The sun didn't want Neha to miss her school bus. Neha again wished the sun would not disturb her. The next day, there was no alarm, no chirping, no sun to wake her up. So Neha kept sleeping. Then she heard her mother's voice. Mother: wake up, sleepyhead. You will miss the bus. Neha: oh no, why does mother have to wake me up? Narrator: there is no escape now. Neha gets up and gets ready. Can you imagine what happens the next day? Neha wakes up with a start. Her watch says it is 6 o'clock. She calls out to her mother. Neha: Ma, who woke me up today? Narrator: mother smiles. Explanation: but there was mother to wake her up. Neha knew her mother would pull her out of bed. She could not escape. She woke up and went to school. However, the next day, Neha woke up with a start. The watch showed the time 6 a.m. Neha asked her mother who woke her up, and on hearing that, her mother smiled at Neha. Mother, who else? You, of course. Neha, but I was sleeping. How could I? Mother, now tell me, why do you eat your lunch every day at 1 in the afternoon? Neha, I feel hungry. Mother, why do you sleep at 9 every night? Neha, because I feel sleepy. Mother, there is a clock inside you, which tells you when to eat, when to sleep, and when to wake up. Neha, oh ho, I better rush now. I don't want to miss the bus. Mother, relax. Today is Sunday. Neha, oh ho ho. Explanation. Her mother explained that she woke up on her own. Neha could not believe it. Mother explained to her that when we do things regularly, it becomes a routine and we wake up at a particular time. Feel hungry almost at the same time daily. Feel sleepy at the same time because our body is tuned to a daily routine. I hope, children, you have understood the chapter. So let's get to some writing work. I want you to also write the meanings of the poem, and that is wake up. The first meaning is lovely, which means very beautiful. Second, buzzing, humming sound. Third, sleepy head, which means a sleepy person. Fourth, tiniest, which means very small. Then I want you to take a new page and write the next chapter, that is Neha's alarm clock. Starting with the hard words. First, snuggles. Second, mutters. Third, windowsill. Fourth, relax. Then we come to the meanings. First, snuggles, which means to be in a comfortable position. Second, mutters, which means say something in a very low voice. Third, windowsill, the bottom part of the window. And fourth, relax, which means free from tension. Let's come to the first question, that is tick the correct answer. First, what time did Neha's clock ring every morning? A, 4 o'clock. B, 9 o'clock. Or C, 6 o'clock. Yes, it rang every day at 6 o'clock in the morning. Second question. What did the birds say? A, sleep on. B, wake up. Or C, go and play. So yes, it is B, wake up. Next, what is inside you that makes you get up at the same time every day? A, our body clock. B, our eyes. C, our feet. So yes, it is A, our body clock. Good. Question number 2. Put the letters in the right order. A, ILESM. When you arrange it in order, the word is SMILE, smile. B, MRALA. The word is alarm. ALARM. Third, C,
सी ओ सी के एल ई. द वर्ड इज क्लॉक. सी एल ओ सी के डी एन ओ आर एम आई एन जी. अरेंज इट इन ऑर्डर एंड द वर्ड कम्स मॉर्निंग. एम ओ आर एन आई एन जी. ई ई डी ओ आर एन एस. द वर्ड इज नोट. एस एन ओ आर ई डी. एफ डब्ल्यू ओ डी डब्ल्यू आई एन. And the word is window, W-I-N-D-O-W. The third and the last question is, who said these words and to whom? First, wake up dear, wake up fast. Who said it? It's the birds. And to whom? To Neha. Next, second, Ma, who woke me up today? Who said it? Neha said it. And to whom did she tell it to? Mother. To her mother. Third, why do you sleep at 9 every night? Who said it? It's mother. To whom? To Neha. Dear children, here we come to the end of Unit 1. I hope you have enjoyed it. Thank you.